Hello, I am Professor Ashwini Deshpande, and in this video I will explain system analysis of LTI system. There are five different ways how we can express for an LTI system an input-output relationship. The first one is an impulse response. Another is a block diagram representation. Third one is using linear constant coefficient difference or differential equation, state variable description, and transfer function. Here we'll look into the approach using impulse response. Impulse response is the term which is the output of an LTI system for both CT system and DT system when input to the system particularly is an impulse function. So the impulse response is expressed as h of t for CT system and h of n for DT system, discrete time system. Impulse response represents an LTI system. Its significance lies in the fact that when we know an impulse response of the system, we can calculate the output of the LTI system for any arbitrary input signal. Thus, for the LTI system, when we know an input to the system and impulse response of the system, we are performing a system analysis by means of a mathematical operation which is termed as convolution, and the output to the system is expressed in terms of a convolution operation. A convolution operation is a mathematical operation that comprises of four different steps, that is folding, shifting, multiplication, and integration, as shown in the formula of convolution integral. The formula of convolution integral is stated as integration from minus to plus infinity x of tau h of t minus tau d tau, where both input signal and the impulse response index t is initially changed to tau. Followed by that, we obtain the folding operation of the impulse response as h of minus tau. After that, we perform shifting operation on h of minus tau, which results into h of t minus tau, and then later we perform multiplication between x of tau and h of t minus tau for the common area or common interval. Followed by that, finally, we perform integration operation. Let us look at the example. For a continuous time LTI system, consider an input to the system is a unit step function, and an impulse response of this LTI system is another unit step function. So let us find out the output of the system for given x of t and h of t. So we start with the initial sketches of x of t, first unit step function, and h of t, that is another unit step function. Being unit step function, both signals have unity amplitude. So in the solution, initially we obtain x of tau and h of tau. This we have changed the index from t to tau. After that, h of tau is folded. It is simply time reversed. After folding operation, this function undergoes shifting, where when initially h of minus tau has started at origin 0 is now displaced to the amount of shift, which is a generalized term now t. In the shifting operation later, this h of t minus tau will be shifted all over the tau to the right hand direction. As discussed before, h of t minus tau, we keep shifting till both the signals, that is x of tau and h of t minus tau, they overlap. It implies that the overlap between x of tau and h of t minus tau, it begins at 0 and it goes up to interval t. So this is where is the common area of overlap, which becomes the limit for the integration when we calculate the output of the system. Also, we can observe here that in the first case, for t less than 0, there is no overlap between x of tau and h of t minus tau. Hence, output will remain 0 for this particular region. And after t 0 or t greater than or equal to 0, we perform the integration where we have substituted in the basic formula of convolution integral the amplitude levels as unity for both x of tau and h of t minus tau being unit step functions. And after the integration, we found that output is resulting into t, which is a ramp function. Thus, the overall output for the system where input was a unit step function and an impulse response was also a unit step function results into a ramp function.